Paul Plakas is here from Custom Fit, and today we're talking about how to exercise when you have an injury. We have Jen who's going to demo. So you're going to fake an injury,
yes,
and then we're going to work through it.
Yeah, so we're going to focus on the three of the major joints in the body. We're going to do the shoulders, something for your knees and your back. Because, you know, when you get hurt, you want to help, you want to start rehabbing the injury, but you also want to keep working out. And so there's certain steps you need to go through so that you don't aggravate the injury further and you can't train anymore.
Right. Let's be clear. Maybe you want to keep working out.
Yeah.
I think a lot of people take the injury as a chance to quit.
To take a little time off. Right?
But they shouldn't. Okay.
So what Jen's going to do here first, she's going to take the tubing, and then we're going to do some. So we're going to do some exercising for the tubing to help encourage development in the shoulder.
And if you don't have a helper like you, just wrap it around anything stable.
Yeah, anything stable. We're starting. What the key for the shoulders is keep your elbows and arms low to start off with, and then build up to doing movements above your shoulders and above your head later on. So we're doing a rowing action. Now she's going to do a cobra action here. So all we're doing here is trying to retract the shoulder blades. In most shoulder injuries, you should be able to do these two before any of the other ones.
Okay.
Because you're putting your shoulder in the safest position and the strongest position in order to get the muscles moving and getting blood flow in there.
Gotcha.
So from there, we would progress to doing some stuff above your head. So now we do external rotation above your head like this. So this is a little bit more aggressive. So if your shoulder feels pain doing this, then regress it back to the other stuff.
Gotcha. Because this is not where your shoulders used to be.
Exactly.
The other one is, so that's what makes it easier.
Exactly. Okay. Yeah, so much easier. So anytime you elevate your shoulder upwards, there's more chance for impingement and strain.
For sure.
And then eventually Jen can just stand on top of the tubing and then progress to pushing weights above her head.
Right.
And that's kind of what you eventually want to get to, because most of the times your shoulders are used to take objects and move them above your head. That's one of their main jobs in your functional day.
Okay.
So that's sort of the progression for shoulders. So now we'll go to knees.
Yes. Okay.
So if you have a knee injury, you know,
maybe you're a runner and everybody has a knee injury.
You hurt it doing something. You want to do some non-weight bearing stuff where you're just getting movement in the joint. So what she's going to do here is just balance on one leg and just lift your knee up and down, just pumping blood into the joint. Okay. Maybe extending the leg back and forth. Like that. If you're in the water, like the water's really good for somebody with knee injuries. The water will give you a little bit of resistance. Plus, it provides you some stability and support as well. So you're not bearing all your load.
Takes all the weight off of your sore knee. Yeah.
Once you progress from that, you can do one leg balancing with arm drivers. So what she's doing here is balancing on one leg, and she's putting stress on the knee joint in all multiple planes. Like her knee has to stabilize here to prevent falling backwards and forwards and from side to side. So this is a more aggressive movement where you're bending laterally this way, and then you can progress finally to where you're doing a rotational one leg balance, and this is something that's even more aggressive. That's sort of the progressions.
Even if you're not hurt, that's going to be hard.
Exactly. But here again, the focus is on stability first, and then you're going to get load and move your body afterwards. So now what she'll do is eventually go to a squat where you kind of want to go to be able to sit back in a chair, sit on the toilet again without having to hold on to stuff, right?
Yes.
And then maybe progressing to a lunge, which is even more aggressive, where you're now using predominantly more one leg to do more of the body weight pushing than the other ones.
Right. Now, what was the other one? Back? Is that the other common injury?
Yeah, then the back ones to finish up. So what we're going to do for her back is maybe do some pelvic tilts.
Yep.
So a little posterior pelvic tilt, just moving your hips back and forth like so.
Yep.
Great. Just getting some movement there and stability. And then maybe you can try something on the floor, hands and knees. And then we're going to try an arm, opposite leg extension.
Right. Start with a small movement, and then as you improve, you can make it bigger and bigger.
Exactly.
Okay, so if you want more information about anything Paul talked about, of course, there's always his website, paulplakas.com, and you can find a link there from our website as well. I think you're officially okay. Injury's over.
I peeled her.
Thanks for coming.